Shocking news on how the police has now waited for nearly 4 hours before taking the victim of a Rajasthan lynch mob to hospital. The man who died, Rakhpar, died because of his injuries. My colleague Harsha Kumari Singh joins us for more on this. Harsha, why didn't the police take him to the hospital? And is there also news to suggest that they were complicit in the attack on this man?
Well, Vishnu, I have spent actually the whole day here in Ramgarh town where this attack happened. It happened about 20 kilometers from here in a place called Lalavandi village, where of course I went also. And I've been trying to piece together the chronology of events, and what's come across is really, really very, very surprising. Now, according to the FIR, which I have looked at and which we have a copy of, at 12:41, the Ramgarh police station, at 12:41 at night, they receive a call from one Naval Kishore. Naval Kishore is a local VHP worker here. He's part of the Gaur Raksha Dal, and he also gave us an extensive interview, which we will play out to you. So he calls them and says that in Lalavandi village, some people have stopped a man with two cows and they are beating him. He's been given a call by one Dharminder and Parminder, and he says that the police should go there. The police ask Naval to accompany him. Now, Naval accompanies them to the village. They reach there at about 1:19, 1:20, according to Naval's interview. They reach there about 1:19, 1:20. They find this man lying in the mud, and these two people, who are now the main accused in the case, they've been charged with murder, Dharminder and Parminder, standing there. They see a mob running away. They take this man out, and then they go with him. They stop at a well, they bathe him, they wash the mud off him. Then they go further and they stop at Naval's aunt's house. And there Naval tries to organize vehicle to transport the cows. Now, this is when a man has been beaten. So he is in the vehicle. They're not rushing with him to hospital, but they're stopping there and organizing a vehicle to transport the cows. After that, they go further and they go and stop at a place called Govindgarh, which is a popular bus stand. I've also interviewed the tea seller, and there they have 4 cups of tea. They ask for 4 cups of tea, and they have tea there, and they're waiting again for this vehicle transporting the cows to meet them. Then, according to Naval, they go to the police station and they leave Rakhpar there. Rakhpar at that point is alive, according to Naval. Naval says, since he's a Gaur Raksha worker, he's from the VHP, he makes no bones about it. His prime concern, of course, is the cows. So he takes the vehicle and goes to the local Gaushala about 15 kilometers away to drop the cows there. The police in the meantime are sitting with Rakhpar inside the police station in their custody. Then I spoke to the doctor, and there is a clear, the doctor's bite, and I have looked at hospital records. They bring Rakhpar to the hospital at 4 a.m. He's brought dead. So from the time 12:41, when they received information about this incident, to 4 a.m. Look at the valuable time that has been lost. Now, whatever Naval may have been done, wasn't it the duty of the police first to take this man to hospital? It's very evident, the post-mortem report is not out yet, but what we have heard from doctors, it's very clear that Rakhpar died due to beating, due to injuries caused due to beating. So really, you know, of course the lynch mob is completely responsible for this, but what about the police's role? Did they not even for a moment think that they should actually have been taking this boy to this man to hospital? Now, I did a ground report from the village where this happened, and you can see there in the clayey soil, the number of footprints that are there, they're still there because the soil is clayey. The number of people who were there at that spot when that happened. I don't know if we have that out or not, and whether we can play it out for our viewers. Vishnu? We are here now at Lalavandi Gaon, where the incident happened, where 28-year-old Rakhpar was allegedly beaten to death for transporting cows. Now, if you can see, this is the field where the incident happened. If you look carefully, you will be able to see that there where there is a lot of water collected, that's because of footprint marks. And because the soil is muddy, the footprints have gone into the soil, and you can see water is collected. So a large number of people, it appears, were in this area, as we can make out from the many footprint marks that are here. But the police have, of course, registered a case against 5 unknown people, and they've arrested 3. They've also said that the investigation could come up with some more names. Now, according to what local people are telling us, this is where the incident happened. This is where the police came, and they found Rakhpar here. And he was, the Haryana border is not very far from here. It's across these fields. So it's there, apparently, where they were headed. Now, there is some contradiction between the police's version And what we have found out here, the police say, according to the FIR, that at about 12:40, they received a phone call from one Naval that an incident had happened. The Ramgarh police station is about a 15-20 minute drive from here. So even if they got here by 1:15, the doctor at the primary health center says the police only came there at about 4 o'clock. And when the police came there, the body, he said he was dead and he was clean. There was no mud or blood on him. So some amount of contradiction between what the police is saying and what the doctor and the locals are saying here. Of course, the investigation will carry on. And according to what the police SP has said, he said he's going to investigate all possible angles. So the Rajasthan government have so far, give you an update, have so far arrested three people for the murder of Rakbar, who was transporting cows. But as you can see here from the footprints, many, many more people were present. In Lalawandi village, Harsha Kumari Singh, NDTV. Well, yes, so that was my report from the ground. Now, after that, the police apparently stopped at a well. They washed the blood and the mud off Rakbar. And then they also stopped at Naval's aunt's house, which is on the way back to the police station. It's towards the village. And she, in fact, spoke to us and she said that she came out and she heard some commotion. And it's really horrific what she said. Let's listen in to what this lady in the village, Maya, in Lalwandi village, said. What was happening with Rakbar when the police had rescued him?
उस रात को हम इधर सो रहे तो रोड़ा हो रहा इधर आवाज से आई तो हम जग के बाहर निकल आए फिर वो ऐसे लात मार रहे उसके
किसको कौन मार रहा है
वो पुलिस वाले मार रहे
किसको
वो लेटा पड़ा ना उसमें मुल्लाओं कौन भाई पता ना तो फिर मैं पहुंची उधर वो गाली वाली सी दे रहे फिर कालन कही नुके चाची तू जा वो गंद बकरे ना गाली बकरे उसको
तो आप हट गए
फिर मैं हट गई
कौन बकरा था
गाड़ी वाले बकरे पुलिस वाले
अच्छा पुलिस वाले ही मार रहे थे पुलिस वाले ही गाली दे रहे थे
हाँ वही मार रहे वही गाली दे रहे उसको
क्या टाइम था ये रात को
भाई टाइम तो मैंने देखा ना
और वो जिंदा लग रहा था आपको या मर गया था
जिंदा उसके कह रहे आगे सरक
Well, so that you heard was the lady who was an eyewitness to what happened just after that incident when the police were taking him away. Now, who is really a very, very crucial and key witness in this whole thing is Naval Kishore. He's a local VHP worker. He's from Lalawandi Gao. And he is the person who informed the police. Apparently, he was informed by Dharminder and Parminder that an incident like this had happened. Now, of course, we know Dharminder and Parminder are the main accused for murder. But Naval Kishore was with the police right through. I did a long interview with him. Let's listen in to what he said. There are many contradictions that are coming across in the police's version and also from the versions of the families that we have spoken to. Well, I have with me someone who's very, very crucial to this case. Now, his name is Naval Kishore. He is from the VHP. And like he just told me a little while ago, he is somebody who is a part of one of the Gauraksha dals of the VHP. Now, it was at night that Naval Kishore received a call from Lalawandi village. In fact, from the two people who are now have been made and accused in this case, and they told him that some people in the village were beating up a man who was transporting cows. So, Naval ji, jab aapko raat ko phone aaya, to Dharminder ka phone aaya, aur usne kya bola aapko?
Dharminder ke phone nahi aaya, meri bhuaji ke bete ka phone aaya. और उस कॉल के बाद मैंने उनको कॉल किया उन्होंने कहा था कि अंकल इस तरह से यहाँ गांव में कुछ गांव के लोग कोई गो तस्कर हैं गाय लेके जा रहे हैं उनको मारपीट कर रहे हैं आप तुरंत पुलिस को भेज दो उनके साथ कोई हादसा हो जाएगा क्योंकि गांव के बहुत सारे लोग हैं मेरे पास जब कॉल आया मैंने पुलिस को फ़ोन किया था 12:41 पे 40 पे उसके बाद मैंने कपड़े वपड़े पहन के जूते वूते पहन के पहुँचा हूँ और उसके बाद जब पुलिस को हमने साथ लिया पुलिस की गाड़ी नहीं थी पुलिस की गाड़ी को आने में 5-7 मिनट लगे और उसको सारे समय को अगर मिलाए तो ये मान लेते हैं अपने 12:55 पे नहीं तो 1 बजे राइट 1:59 के आसपास निकले हैं और 1 बज के 15 से 20 मिनट के बीच में हम बिल्कुल घटनास्थल पर पहुंच गए एक बंदा कीचड़ में पूरा सना हुआ लेटा पड़ा था और जिन बंदों ने सूचना दी मैंने उनको वहाँ रहने के लिए बोला था कि गांव के लोग हैं तो मारपीट कर रहे हैं आप उस जगह पे पहुंचो हम पहुंच रहे हैं मैं पुलिस के साथ हूँ वो वहाँ प्रेजेंट में हमें मिले बाकी गांव के लोगों को हमने जाते हुए देखा पुलिस ने भी उनको भागते हुए देखा है पुलिस की गाड़ी को जब ऊपर जो लाइट का जो लाइटिंग होती है तो उसको देख के भागे उन्होंने सायरन वगैरह तो नहीं बजाया था बाकी वो भाग गए तो रात का अंधेरा था तो मैं भी नहीं पहचान पाया क्योंकि मेरे गाँव के बंदे मैं अगर उजाला होता तो मैं एक दो को पहचान भी सकता था
Well, so that was Naval Kishore. He's very, very crucial in this case. Also, interestingly, we've just been told that the police have got a 5-day custody of these three accused. Parminder, Naresh and Dharminder Yadav, who are in the police station right now here. A 5-day police remand for them. Of course, now, also earlier in the day, I spoke to some relatives of Parminder and on exactly what happened. We also spoke to the police SP of Alwar. Let's listen in. It's here in Ramgarh police station that you can see that the three accused are being kept right now. Now, they have been arrested and they will be charged with murder. But a lot of their family people are also here and they are saying that actually there's a different version to this whole story, that once they informed the police, the police reached there. In fact, the police, they say, took Rakhbar to the police station. Now, let me ask one of them, bhaiya, aapko kya lag raha hai ki inko galat fasaya ja raha hai?
Ji, ma'am.
आपको लग रहा है कि गलत फंसाया जा रहा है, क्यों आप क्यों लगता है आपको
गलत फंसाया जा रहा है?
क्यों लगता है कि गलत?
क्योंकि मैम, अगर ये दोषी होते तो खुद ही क्यों फोन करके पुलिस को बोलते? खुद ही इन्होंने पुलिस को फोन करके बुलाया है, नवल जी साथ रहे हैं, फिर गांव वाले भी कुछ बता रहे हैं, भाई हमारे सामने इनकी मारपीट हुई है, पुलिस वाले इनको मार रहे हैं, और वहाँ से फिर इन्होंने पुलिस वालों ने हेल्प मांगी है परमजीत और धर्मेंद्र से, भैया आप हमारे साथ चलो, ये गाय हमारा वहाँ छोड़ जाओ, जबकि वो उनका काम नहीं था, पुलिस जैसे मर्जी लाती, उनका काम था उनको सौंप देना बस।
परमिंदर FIR में तो लिखा है कि परमिंदर वहाँ खड़ा था और रकबर कीचड़ में पड़ा था, ऐसे लिखा है।
मैम, बारिश थी, जो भीड़ थी, गांव वाले थे, जो वो गाड़ी देख के, उन्होंने भी देखा है, पुलिस वालों ने भी देखा है कि गाड़ी को देख के वो भाग गए। हो सकता है गाँव वालों ने उनको हाथापाई की हो, मारी हो, या जैसे अकबर भाग रहा था, एक बंदा तो भाग रहा था, आई थिंक उसके पैर में कुछ फ्रैक्चर आया था, तो वहाँ पे पड़ा हुआ था क्योंकि चल नहीं पा रहा था, वो पैर में उसके था, फ्रैक्चर था।
तो आपका ये आरोप है कि पुलिस उसको हॉस्पिटल नहीं लेके गई सही?
वो बंदा रास्ते में खत्म हो गया, उसकी ऐसी कंडीशन थी सीधा हॉस्पिटल लेके जाती ना, फिर 3 घंटे तक यहाँ पे क्यों रखा?
अच्छा, पुलिस स्टेशन में लेके आए हैं वो?
स्टेशन में लेके आए हैं, इसका हमारे पास गवाह है नवल किशोर जी, वो पुलिस वालों के साथ था। अच्छा, पूरा लेके आए हैं वो थाने में, यहाँ पे वो उसको रखा है, फिर पुलिस वाले साथ गए हैं गौशाला में। अगर वो बंदा इतना सीरियस था, उसको पहले हॉस्पिटल लेके जाते, पहले गांव को छोड़ने क्यों जाते?
आप परमिंदर के क्या लगते हैं?
ब्रदर बड़ा।
So that was what you heard of the relatives speaking to us. Now after this, we also spoke to the police SP and we brought some of these points to his notice, that you know the role of the police is also something that they should look at. Well, he said he's just taken over his new posting. He was not in the district. He's just taken over, and he said all aspects of the case will be investigated. So I really think in this case, of course, given the kind of evidence that is emerging, the police really needs to look at its own role. Now, what time did they bring the body in? That's very crucial. So like you know, at 12:41, they get an information at night that the man has been beaten by some village people in Lalavandi. What time did they go with the body? Remember, by now he had died. What time did they go with the body to the health center? Let's listen in to what the doctor said.
सुबह 4 बजे, शार्प 4 बजे मेरे पास कॉल आया मेरे स्टाफ का, और उन्होंने बताया कि सर एक मृत अवस्था लग रही है, बाकी आप एक बार आके देख लीजिए। तो मैं नीचे आया तो मतलब ऑलरेडी डेड था, और 4-5 पुलिस वाले थे और 2 लड़के थे साथ में, एक सरदार जी थे और एक लड़का और था, और फिर मैंने उसको डिक्लेयर कर दिया तुरंत कि इसमें कुछ नहीं है, और पोस्टमार्टम अगर आप पोस्टमार्टम फॉर्मेलिटी अगर करनी है तो इसको शिफ्ट करा दें मॉर्चरी में, और इसका नाम पता मैंने बोला कि इसका नाम पता लिख लीजिए। बॉडी नेक स्टिफनेस था उसको, मैं उसको देख के लग रहा था कि तकरीबन इसको 2-3 घंटे हो चुके हैं उसके मरे हुए।
So really now the critical question is, when you get a lynch mob victim who has been beaten by village people, what should the police have been doing? Should they not have gone straight to hospital with them? If they had, perhaps they would have saved Rakbar's life. Back to you, Vishnu.